Hi, everybody. You got it locked to the Tanya Mullings Show on the BarnBurner TV network on Zingo TV channel 250. You can download the Zingo TV app for any iOS or Android device and watch it on any smart TV. And I am so excited today. I have three talented brothers here from Edmonton, Alberta, the Melisizwe Brothers. Welcome to the show, guys.
Hey, how's it going?
It's good. How are you doing? All locked up inside.
Oh, we're awesome. We're trying to stay here. We're trying to stay safe. But anyway, we're doing great. We're doing really awesome. We're still playing music.
Well, you guys, I know you guys are working hard all the time. So being locked up, it's probably not a big thing for you because I see you guys, you have your YouTube channel, you're constantly recording and getting stuff out there. So you are constantly busy.
Yeah, I mean, we're keeping busy by, you know, doing our music, you know, keeping our fans entertained, you know, we're uploading, you know, and sometimes you get to do a little exercise, so that's a good thing as well.
And we're also working with a lot of different artists and writers, and we're actually putting out a song every day, so we've been keeping busy.
Yep, so before I go any further, you guys go ahead and introduce yourself to my viewers.
All right, so I'm Zachary, I am 12 years old. And I'm the lead singer of the group.
I'm Seth, and I'm 14 years old, and I'm the pianist of the group.
I'm Mark, and I'm 17 years old, and I'm the guitarist of the group.
Wow. I just want to say shout out to your mom and dad. And, you know, they must be extremely proud of you three boys. I mean, I'm sure Edmonton is very proud of you boys. And the whole of Canada. I was telling your parents, your dad, that I was not aware. I live here in Toronto. Well, we say Brampton, Ontario. And I saw you guys on all these shows. And, you know, I did not even realize you were from here. I thought you were from the States.
Oh.
I really did. I mean, that wouldn't have made a difference if you were from the States. I would have had you on the show anyways. But I just thought you were. You've been everywhere. So I just assumed you were from over there.
Right.
A lot of people say that. That we're from Africa, we're from Brazil, and it's kind of crazy, but we always tell them that we were born in Canada, but we like to say that our music is for everyone, right? So, yeah.
So where are your parents from?
Our parents are actually from a small island in the Caribbean. They're from St. Vincent. So they're from St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And yeah, we like it a lot there. It's very beautiful. We like to visit there sometimes and everything's really nice.
My two boys, their father is from St. Vincent. So I'm aware of St. Vincent.
Nice.
Yeah?
Awesome.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Do you guys want to start off and sing a little something before we get into more background?
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah.
For
sure.
What would you like to do?
This is actually one of our original songs that we released. It was in January, actually. It's called Stadium.
Okay.
Right.
The Melisizwe Brothers singing their brand new track. You can get it online called Stadium.
Maybe it's just the neon lights, but I see rainbows in your eyes. We've gone too far to turn back now. Your beauty's louder than the crowds, and you were there, but now we're here, and it's like time just disappears. We got these chills when all is still, the music stops. We found in love in the stadium. 100,000 our folks in the sky. But it's only yours and mine inside this stadium. We found in love in the stadium. 100,000 people get tonight. But it's only you and I inside this stadium. Hold your head, I wanna pull you close, I wanna let you know. Oh, oh, oh. The lights go on and everyone goes home. I'm never I want to hold your hand, I want to pull you close, I want to let you know who I am. When the lights go on and everyone goes home, we fell in love in a stadium. We fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 iPhones in the sky, but it's only yours and mine inside this stadium. We fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 people get tonight, but it's only you and I inside this stadium.
Wow. Wow, guys. Did you guys write that, or did the record company do that one for you?
This song was actually with Republic Records. So it was when we flew down to LA and we did the song with Republic Records. So yeah, that's
okay. So you wrote it? I'm not hearing Mark too clearly.
So we actually didn't write the song, but okay. We actually picked the song because we really loved the song and what it really talked about. And, you know, when we picked Stadium, it really pushed us, you know, further, because now we got to perform this song maybe in stadiums. And it's a really cool song. We really liked it when we picked it. So.
Well, you can certainly fill stadiums already. So it was a perfect song for you guys. I wanted to talk how you guys started off singing. What made you say, okay, I can do this? How did this all come about? Is your parents have a musical background?
Well, it really started out with, I think it started out with mom and dad, because, you know, our dad, he actually, a long time ago, he dabbled in like instruments like the piano and the bass. And, you know, our mom, she really liked to sing when she was really little. You just have her singing all the time. So it actually started off with Mark. So Mark, why don't you go ahead and tell like how you started? So how it happened.
Well, ever since I was little, I loved to sing. One time I had my mom buy a Jackson CD album. And at home we had this small CD player and you could sing karaoke to it. So all the time I would put in that Jackson CD album and I would be singing all the songs. And one day my mom came into my room and she saw me singing Who's Loving You? And then she took a video and she showed my dad, and my dad said, Mark can sing. So then he decided that I was gonna take lessons, and Zachary pretty much grew up seeing me doing all these performances, like our talent shows, and he saw me singing classical opera. And so Zachary kind of grew from there. Zachary and Seth's story is a little bit different. Let me hand it over to Seth.
Yeah, so.
Okay, but Mark, how old were you when that happened, when you were doing that, when your mom filmed you?
Well, I was three.
Three?
Yeah, I was three and I was singing Jackson 5.
Wow.
I was even doing splits, and I can't.
Can you still do the splits?
Maybe not anymore.
That means you got to train some more. So, okay, continue the story.
Yeah, so how Zachary and I got into music, well, it was from our mom's coworkers. So she gave her a piano, and so our mom brought it home. It was a small, like, keyboard. So Zachary and I, we really, really loved the keyboard, you know. We were playing on it every day. We were playing back the little sample tracks like Hey Jude, you know. And so our parents saw that we really loved piano. So that's how we got into piano lessons. And so
okay.
I found a love for piano, and Zachary, that's how he got started. So from there on, we, you know, it's been like 4 years later, and now Zachary, he played the drums, he played like the violin, played the guitar, and, you know, he kept adding from there on. And so that's when in 2015, we actually moved to St. Vincent. And so where, you know, we settled in and we like came together as a group and said, you know, guys, it would be really great if we start a band. And so that's kind of how our band started. We focused really a lot on our music, and, you know, we practiced every day. So, and then Zachary, why don't you take it from there? That's
your... But let me interrupt before Zachary starts. You guys were born in Canada or in St. Vincent?
We were all born in Canada.
Okay, nice. Okay, but before Zachary continues, I saw a video of you guys in St. Vincent doing like an anthem for St. Vincent, like tourist kind of video.
That's actually your song. It's called Welcome to St. Vincent.
And okay.
We did that song, you know, just to make people, you know, appreciate our homeland. And it was just a really special song. We wanted to write it. And we wrote that song actually in 2015. So it's been a while since
then. Very good. I thought when I saw that, I thought, like, I know your parents are from there, but I thought maybe you guys were over here, made it so big, and then they went back there and embraced you. Like, these kids are my parents came in, and they go, we got to get these kids to do this anthem for St. Vincent. That's what I thought it was. That was beautiful.
Yeah. A lot of our growth before really hitting big was actually in St. Vincent. In 2015, we were doing performances all over the island, and eventually it came to a point when everybody knew who we were, so we had to come back to Canada so that we could actually grow more and like be who we are now, right? So
The islands love the music. I see you guys doing a little reggae. That's my thing. I saw that. So Zach, continue the story, honey.
Well, after we moved in St. Vincent, it was 2015, right? And I actually got to focus more on instruments. So how I started was I started with the piano, same as Seth. But and after that, I was actually the drummer of the group. Though I actually started on piano, I actually drum. Mark was actually the lead singer. Mm-hmm. Mark played the guitar, and then Seth played the piano. And then our dad, like, we would jam every day in the basement. Well, not every day in the basement, but like on weekends in the basement, and we just play fun songs and everything. And there I figured out that I had perfect and relative pitch because I played lots of instruments at the time. I played the violin and the keyboard, and it just really, all those instruments really came to me with all the practice that we had. And then until 2015 is when we decided to, you know, take music on another level with my brothers. And, you know, music was really fun. Back then it was really fun for me just to discover what I was really good at, which was music. And that's really how I started.
So when you decided to, I know you guys said you did some training, but before, the way you were talking, it sounded like, did you actually just pick up the instruments and play by ear before you got serious more into the training?
Well, we actually, when we started, when Seth and I started keyboard lessons, it was more by ear until we got into piano lessons. And I actually read drum music, and we're actually classically trained. So yeah, we read music.
So before I get more into you guys, just to ask you, because you said your mom and dad were in music, were they performing a lot around the island as well, your parents, at a younger age?
Well, it wasn't like they were like actual performers. They kind of like did it for fun. So, you know, dad, like in church, he would usually like, he'd watch the pianist sometimes. So that's how he learned how to play the bass and the piano. But our mom, she just loved to sing naturally. So, you know, sometimes you could just catch her singing and she'd be singing like a Whitney Houston song, or she'd be singing like anything. So they kind of like, they did it for fun, right?
So what you're saying is mommy and daddy don't like the spotlight like you guys.
Yeah, they're more on the down low, you know.
I know what that feels like. I don't know if your dad told you, but my father was my manager and he was the upfront person. And he didn't sing or anything, but my mom never really came around. She came to the shows, but she was very in the back. She didn't like no spotlight. So I know what that's like. Yep. So I wanted to talk to you guys about all the... For what you've done in such a short span of time, some artists don't do that in a full career. Like you have, I don't know which one you did in what order, if you want to verify that for me. Your first competition, which one was that one?
Well, our first competition was actually the Apollo.
Yeah.
That was in 2017.
That was the Christmas special one?
That was the Christmas special in the year. And being at the Apollo was really fun. It was really special. You know, meeting Steve Harvey. Steve Harvey's really awesome. He's really funny.
He's funny. Isn't he funny? Yeah, I like the part when he said that you're really his children. He's got some news for you. You're his children. That was funny. Yeah, but I caught a clip of that one, and you were rubbing when you went on, everybody thought that was so cute. And when you won, oh, you were just so emotional, you know? It was just so cute. And you know what? You are young. You were young at that time, and you're still young at 12, but that showed you're so humble and you're so appreciative of what you have. And you three boys will go so far with that attitude. And I mean, you should be extremely proud of yourselves. Like, I mean, very mature, like even the way you guys are speaking, you're like tossing it off. Like you've been in this game a long time, real professional, you know, it's really, really good. Your parents should be extremely proud once again. So you did in that one that you did at the Apollo Theater, that was I didn't catch the whole thing. So was that a one-time competition or was it weeks?
That one was a one-time competition. So it was a Christmas special. So, you know.
And you won.
And we won that one.
Yeah. So that was the first step. That was the first competition?
Yeah, that was actually the first national TV competition we've ever been on.
Wow. Okay. And so then after you did that one, were you ever on the Big Shot? Is it Big Shots that Steve Harvey host? Were you on that one or no? Just the UK one?
We're on Little Big Shots UK. We got to meet Don French, and it was really awesome there. It was our first time in London as well. So it's an amazing city.
And wow. Yeah, I've been there. It's a nice place. It's always foggy there though, but it's nice. So then you went on to what else? You went on to another competition. I know all the competitions. I just want to put it out there, the order that you went in them and how they all went about. What was the next one?
The next one was America's Got Talent.
America's Got Talent. I wanted to ask you guys a question. I'm just curious, and you guys would probably have the answer to this. When you say America's Got Talent, I always thought that show that you couldn't go on that show because you were Canadian, so they would just be focusing on, that's why I thought you were from the States, to be honest. I thought they would only allow people to compete who were in the States. How did that work?
On America's Got Talent, so we actually did meet a couple of other contestants from Canada as well, like Vancouver, Toronto. And same thing for America's Most Musical Family. There were actually a couple of families from Canada as well. So it wasn't
like just America. You were able to go outside of America. No, that's a great thing. I was just curious because, like I said, that's why I thought you guys were from the States, just because of the name of the competition.
So some contestants who are from Colombia as well, so from South America as well. So we actually got to meet them. So they actually do have contestants outside of America.
Okay. So when you went on that one, you got America's Top Talent, right? Yeah. Was that correct? You won that one too?
America's Most Musical Family.
Yeah, America's Most Musical Family too. Right?
So the America's Got Talent, did you win that one or no?
Oh, we actually didn't win that one, but you know,
our case for America's Got Talent was kind of special. They saw us on a video through our Facebook. So they called us and they said, do you guys want to appear on our show? So we were really excited because obviously it's the first time being on America's Got Talent. And so we said, yeah. So what happened is that we flew over and we appeared as guest performers for their show.
Oh, wow. Okay, well, that's a good thing. If they're reaching out to you, you didn't even have to audition. That says a lot. I was just going to say, you didn't win that. So you weren't in the competition to compete. You were just there as a guest? Or was it for the competition?
Our appearance was as guests.
Okay. I was just going to say you didn't win America's Got Talent, but you went and won the other one. And that's better, guys. is it? Out of 30?
America's most musical family.
That is amazing. Oh my gosh, you guys. And that how that was intense competition. It was weeks of that, was it not?
Yeah, it was when we were there filming America's Most Musical Family, it was long, but you know, we still enjoyed it because we got to meet like a ton of families. We got to learn about them, but also we got to work with like a lot of producers, professionals, and it was just really fun there, right? And a lot of hard work as well. So, yeah.
But I don't want to skip forward because I want to talk about your new singles now, because I know you have other stuff up, but I just wanted to make a point when you just said that you got to work with a lot of professionals. I saw a video of you guys in the studio working on a song, and you're saying, and they were talking very highly of you because you guys just went in there and took over and just like you were seasoned musicians showing them what you wanted to do. And that was something. Oh. I know I can tell, you know, I'm an artist as well. And I just was like, wow, look at these kids. Like, you know what you want. And that's a good sign of a good artist, that you just go in there and you're not just sitting back as three kids, you know, being produced. You actually really have a say in what you're doing at this young age. And they're really blown away by you as, you know, seasoned musicians and also producers. So that says a lot for you guys.
That's really important because that's really important because you have to like really know what you want. You don't want to go there and you don't know what you want, because that's time on your hands, right? So you have to use that time properly and you have to know what you want so that the outcome is really great and it's successful. Yeah.
That's great that you have a say. So I'm going to, before we get more music talk, I'm just going to ask, I see this togetherness. You guys are like, is there any like, you know, bickering or fighting like brothers? You got any of that going on? Who's the boss?
Sometimes we do.
Well, actually most of the time we fight and argue, but you know, that's like a normal part of, you know,
being brothers. Yeah.
Each of us understand that what we going on is a teamwork effort. Because of Zachary's perfect pitch, he is the musical leader of our group. So when Zachary hears something, we let him do his thing. And me and Seth are just trying to do our best to support him from behind and making sure that we're all stronger together, right?
So, yeah, you guys, just your personalities all mesh. You know, I can see that, you know, and I'll say something to you that I told your father. I know Seth celebrated a birthday, am I correct? April 17th?
Yes, you can.
And we're close, Zach and I. My birthday's today, May 17th. I'm so happy to have you guys on my show on my birthday. I will remember this COVID-19 birthday, having you guys on my show. So again, happy early birthday to you, Zachary. And Mark, you celebrated a birthday March 11th, and that is my father's birthday.
Oh, nice.
And yes, and my father, like I said, was my manager, and unfortunately we lost him 14 years ago. So the relationship I see with the three of you guys, that I'm into signs, and I see the meshing with the three of you, and it's just lovely. It's absolutely lovely.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. So do you want to sing something else before we talk a little more?
Oh, yeah. I know.
Okay.
We were planning this. We want to sing you happy birthday. Is it okay if we can?
Yeah. I didn't just say that for you to sing me happy birthday, but it was good timing. Oh, I would love that, guys. Thank you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Tanya. Happy birthday to you.
Oh my gosh, I wish I had the audience back there. Woo! Thank you so much, guys. That was so nice. Oh, that was very thoughtful. Thank you. Thank you to your dad. I'm sure he told you guys that. Oh my goodness. I'm speechless, and I'm never speechless. Ooh. Yeah, that was lovely, guys. What could I say? What are you guys, let me see. What are you working on now? Like song was, you had a song. Oh, let me ask you something. I don't want to get into that yet, but I saw a song and I'm not sure because you guys do a lot of cover songs. Yeah. I know you put on your thing. Is Journey of Life a cover song or is that original?
That's a Journey of Life is an original song.
Okay, so that's what I wanted to know because a lot of people see you doing the covers. Oh, before I'm getting off topic. I just thought of something too when you were singing, Zach. Like we all know, you sound like Michael Jackson, okay? And there's another video of you where you're singing and you kind of move a little bit like Stevie Wonder. And like, oh my gosh, like I already know that those two are your favorite vocalists. And you can clearly see that even if you didn't say it. But I was like, I looked at the three of you and I said, these are like, it's like Michael Jackson, the Jackson three, your mom and dad were just short two more. That's it. They should have went back for two more and you would have been even, you know, but I've never seen this, you know, and it's like, has anybody, I know you got a chance to meet Stevie Wonder. Tell the story of that and then I'll finish what I was saying, what that was like.
You mind if I finish that?
Yeah, go ahead, man.
Okay.
You're the guy who loves them.
So we met Stevie actually in 2017, in April 2017. And, you know, it was the story is kind of a little bit weird, but, you know, it's pretty cool. And when actually Stevie, he actually contacted us and they said that Stevie wanted to meet us actually. And we didn't know, only our parents knew that we were gonna meet Stevie, but we didn't know. So we thought we were gonna do an audition down in LA. So we flew down to LA and we went to a studio and we walked into the room thinking that somebody was gonna, and our dad told us to play when the person came in. So when that person came in, it was actually Stevie Wonder. And I was like, whoa. I was like, whoa. That was super cool. So, and dad told us to play no matter what and not to stop. So we played our set and it was pretty emotional. But, you know, he's really cool. He showed us a lot of stuff and we had a lot of fun.
So did you, when you say you were like, whoa, did you forget your words and like stop and start again? That's like, I could imagine how you must have felt because he's your idol.
I probably almost did, but I was good with my words. I got my words.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah? So you were okay. Did you ever, you know, the fact that you met Stevie Wonder and the fact that you've met Steve Harvey and you sound like Michael Jackson, has anybody ever... or have you ever got a chance to meet any of the Jacksons?
Well, not yet. We haven't met any of the Jacksons yet. But
we have actually talked with Tito over the phone. I mean, like, we keep in contact with some of them, but, you know, we're always planning on going down to LA and just hanging out sometime. It just hasn't happened yet.
Wow. See, that would be marvelous. Like, I'm like, how come Quincy Jones doesn't, you know... Have you heard from him?
Quincy Jones, we haven't heard from him yet, but I'm pretty
Zachary
sure.
Zachary did actually go down to LA with dad to meet
Berry Gordy. Berry Gordy of Motown.
So. Did you get to meet him?
Yeah, I actually got to meet him. It was actually for an audition, and I actually got to meet Berry Gordy for the first time. It was actually pretty cool.
And what can you say what he had to say to you, or you can keep that private? It's up to you.
Well, what Berry Gordy said, it was awesome meeting. He said that I was really great, you know, at my singing skills and everything. So he was really, I think he was blown away. He was really blown away. So yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm in the business too, and I cannot see how you three boys could be. You know, they not want to you know, just embrace that, because we don't, there's a lot of people that imitate, but there's no other Michael Jackson. And you see a lot of kids imitating that, but they haven't quite got it right on. And you got it right on. Like, it's like, wow, you know, I have a little son who's 5 and he's running around the house singing Stadium all the time. And he said, "Mommy, can I meet those boys?" And he doesn't get excited. He's like, "Can I come on your interview?" So it's like, that just shows my little son never knew Michael Jackson, and he's just in awe over Michael Jackson. So when he hears you sing, he's thinking, that's Michael Jackson. That's what he said. He said he thinks it's Michael Jackson little because he's hearing that. So that's a good thing when you affect the little ones like that. And like, Michael's gone now and he's still affecting kids coming now, and they don't even know he's gone or whatever, you know. That just shows what music can do, how you influence others, you know.
Yeah,
it's so true.
Yeah. So you guys want to sing something else? Or
oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Let's see what we can do.
Yeah, Stevie.
All right, we'll do My Shitty More.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, My Shitty More, my Stevie.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you got to show some Stevie. The Melisizwe Brothers, you're watching.
La, 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 la. Distant as the Milky Way, my shady, you know, pretty little one that I adore. You're the only one my heart beats for. I wish that you were mine. In a cafe, sometimes on a crowded street, I believe you, but you never noticed me. Oh, oh, my Chevy, you know, won't you tell me how could you know that behind that little smile I wore, I always think you were mine. La, 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 la. Maybe someday see my face among the crowd. Oh, maybe someday I'll share that little distant cloud. Oh, my shady, you're more pretty little one that I adore. You're the only one my heart beats for.
Melisizwe Brothers. Oh my gosh, Stevie Wonder. Nice. We still got time left, but I just want you guys to let them know all your social media, where to find you. If you can tell them that, my viewers.
We're all over YouTube. So we have our YouTube channel. We're on Instagram. Our Instagram is the Melisizwe Bros.
Right.
And we have our Twitter. Our Twitter is Melisizwe_Bros. And then we have our Facebook. You can follow us on Facebook.
The Melisizwe Brothers again.
So yeah.
Is Mark the network guy? Because you keep looking at Mark. I was confused when I messaged, I got Mark, and then he says, call Mark. And then I go, oh, there's two Marks. Mark, little Mark and big Mark. How is that when you get called from your mom around the house? Do you both look?
Oh, sometimes. When dad is here, sometimes. Mark will be
trying to call dad, babe.
Mark, and then Mark will be like, huh, or something.
Yeah, that must be different. Mark Jr. Okay, what was I going to say? I wanted to talk about you. We're talking about Stevie Wonder, and I heard a part on your interview when you were talking about meeting him that he took you somewhere and gave you something special.
Oh, yeah. He actually took us in LA to the Guitar Center. And the Guitar Center is really huge. It has like lots of instruments. And you know, he told us, pick what you like. And I chose this bass guitar. This bass guitar actually came from Stevie Wonder.
And wow.
Mark got a guitar.
Yeah.
And Seth, the keyboard that he's playing on right now, that is actually from Stevie Wonder.
And wow.
Just want to thank him for that because, you know, he allowed us to, you know, expand in our music. Yeah, he's really awesome.
Wow, that's so nice. So is that when you did that? Okay, let me understand this now. You just got all this stuff from Stevie Wonder, right? So now how many years has this been since you were singing to when you got this from Stevie Wonder together as a group?
This was 3 years. 3 years from then.
Totally, we've been singing together as a group for 7 years.
8 years, actually.
Eight years.
Yeah.
So 8 years, you go on all these talent shows, you meet Stevie Wonder, right? Am I right?
Yeah. You meet
Steve Harvey. Oh, you went also on from the Apollo Theater to Steve Harvey's show. How was that?
Yeah, the Steve Harvey show, it's really cool. And when we got to perform there for the Christmas episode, it was really awesome, you know. Steve Harvey's awesome as well. You know, it was an awesome experience being on the Steve Harvey show.
So you guys aren't blown away that all this has happened in this 8 years?
Well, I'm pretty blown away because I think it was being traveling around the world and meeting new people is also really awesome. And being with my brothers, especially doing this, I'm really like blown away by that. But especially in a different way, it's kind of like when I'm blown away, I'm like kind of calm, you know. I don't really show it so much, but yeah, it really shows what I feel inside, right? So it was really.
But, awesome. You know, I don't know about you guys, but I assume it's like this with you practice a lot and you put a lot into your craft. Do you not? You spend hours practicing, don't you?
Well, every day we're doing something that involves music. So music is our life. We just love music. And like we're working on songs so that after this is over, we can go on tour and we can be releasing a new album. And we're just, we love music. It's as simple as that. Yeah.
So do you find it, are you homeschooled?
Yeah, we are homeschooled. It's our fourth year now.
Do you feel like, you know, I know homeschool goes along with all the recording and the touring your guys are doing, but do you find that you miss out in going to that everyday school like everybody else does, or are you cool with that?
Well, I mean, we're pretty cool. We make sure that we stay as active as possible. Like we're always calling our friends and we're making sure that we keep in touch so that when everything is over and done with, we can work out on meeting up and hanging out again. So we still try to keep positive and keep the community going, right?
Yeah, I was like that growing up, and people never understood it. I wasn't homeschooled. I went to school, but I practiced a lot and I stayed home, and my friends would go to parties and I'd be like staying home, and they're like, oh, you're so boring. I said, no, I know what I wanted to do. And I stayed home and I practiced because I had something, I was at a goal to reach, you know? So I totally understand that. But I was just wondering if you guys get to make, you almost have the story like the Jacksons, where they were like, Joe Jackson had them constantly working on their craft and everything like that, that they really didn't get that time to be with their friends, you know? So, I mean, that comes with the territory, but I was just wondering if you guys feel like you're missing out on any of that, not being in school every day and seeing your friends like all the time because you're, you know, doing your craft.
Well, as a group, we make sure that we understand what it takes. And if music is something, we wouldn't be doing it if we didn't love it. And by the way, Zachary smiles when he sings. Oh. You can tell that he is in love with music.
Look at me. When I watch you, I'm like this. It's like, I'm a mom. So I think every mother out there would look at you guys and be extremely proud. Your parents, you know, we, as parents, you can't be more prouder. You know what I mean? But I want to make sure, because I talk about this before we get out of here, is since you were talking about Stevie Wonder giving you instruments, was that what made you start the gold mine project, music project?
Well, yes. A part of that is that it got us to start the gold mine, the music program.
Because Stevie Wonder was definitely one of the roots to the beginning of our gold mine music program. It was a huge impact on us, especially on Zach, because Zachary has never been evermore. He actually got a harmonica that is the exact same type as the one that Stevie Wonder is using. This is the one that he got.
Oh, he's showing me it. He's showing me it.
This is the harmonica that I got from Stevie.
You play that too?
Yeah, I play harmonica as well. Yeah.
Oh my good. What you don't do?
Huh?
What don't you do?
I play a ton of instruments. Instruments in their houses, not everybody, but that's what I do. I'm like the instrument kind of guy in the group that
you know? Just dabble in everything. Is there a difference between the Gold Mine music program and instrument program, or are they the same thing?
Well, it's the same thing overall, because the Gold Mine music program is where we actually visit schools and we meet the students and we tell them about our whole musical journey. And we also gather these instruments that they would donate, and we give them to kids who have a passion, or individuals who have a passion who want to begin their own musical journey. So we've been doing this for the past year now, and it's grown quite a bit.
Wow, that's something so nice of you guys to do. So if people want to, if somebody wants an instrument or needs one, how do they go about getting that?
Well, we have on our website, they could contact, send us a message through our website, and we would look for somebody who's willing to donate the instrument, and then we would facilitate that instrument to them, right?
So you'll facilitate it to the person looking for one. So there's a, at your website, there is somewhere to ask for an instrument and there's somewhere to donate it, correct?
Yep, on our website, if you go to our Goldmine Music Program page, then you'll be able to find an email that you can send us a message to, and we'll do our best to help you start your musical journey.
That is such an amazing thing you guys are doing. Very nice. Very, very nice idea, because, you know, we all know there's kids out there that can't afford it and would love to be doing what you're doing. A lot of them go into music classes and the parents can't afford to get those instruments for them. So that is absolutely amazing. Thank you for that.
No problem.
One more I missed. You went on Ellen.
Oh,
how
yeah.
was that?
That was in 2016.
Yeah. So the Ellen show is actually the first national broadcast show that we actually went on. So it was ever since we came back from St. Vincent, you know, we went like viral in Brazil. And so our video of I Look to You and I'll Be There took off. again twice. So I'll be there on Facebook. Was actually 55 million. It was actually 15 million views. So Ellen saw that. And so
she actually called us and she's like, oh, you guys want to be in our show? And we're like, yeah, we want to be on your show. This is like the biggest thing ever, right? And so,
like, you're going to say no, right? You're going to say, Ellen's calling. No, we can't make it.
Meeting Ellen was really awesome. She's really generous. You know, she helps a lot of people.
Yeah, DeGeneres. That's just her name.
Yeah, and she's, I almost like cried in the back with that, but you know, it's tears showing and everything.
You know, you're very much like me. We're Taurus. I get very sensitive. You get so touched because you know what it is? It hits you and you go, I'm here. And I think with you guys, every time you make a step to something further, your hard work is what brings the tears and that tears of joy, because you realize it didn't come easy for you to get where you were. And you're very appreciative of it, you know? And people are seeing, like, it doesn't come overnight. But for you guys, I don't know what you're doing. You're doing whatever you're doing. It's coming overnight. And it's a good thing. You don't get any sleep, but it's worth it, you know? So I'm not sure if I left anything out. I tried to cover the gold mine project. I had said to your dad, I don't know if you want to give, just because I keep talking about you sound like Michael Jackson. Could you give me a little bit of Michael Jackson so just they can hear you?
Yeah, for sure.
If you have anything, if you don't have anything ready for that one, because I know sometimes.
Yeah, let's go in the, One, two, three.
Brothers.
You and I must make a bed. We must bring salvation in. Where there is love, I'll be there. I reach out my hand to you. I love faith in all you do. Just call my name and I'll be there.
Oh, 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 I'll be there to comfort you in the world of dreams around you. I'm so glad that I found you. I'll be there with your heart strong. I'll be your strength. I'll keep hope in the home. Yes, I'll be
holding on.
If you should ever find someone new, I know we better feel good to you. Cause if he doesn't, I'll be there. Don't you know, baby, yeah, I'll be there. Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
Look at this song, sonny.
Oh, I'll be there. Oh, I'll be there. Oh, just call my name.
It froze. Nice, guys. It froze a little on me. I wasn't sure if you were done. Amazing. Thank you so much for that one. Listen, you guys ever come to Toronto and perform?
Yeah, we actually came to Toronto last year and we did a concert. Actually,
yeah.
May we did a concert in Toronto.
Oh, man, you gotta let me know when you're coming. I'm gonna be front row, okay? Yeah. All right. I'm going to be front row, that's for sure. Oh my goodness, you guys, I can't say thank you enough. I think this has probably been the best birthday for me. Nobody can complain about being stuck in here with this COVID-19. I'm going to remember this one, that's for sure. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. This was not planned for this day, but it's been the best birthday that I could wish for.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, are you? It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Again, they're from Edmonton, Alberta. The Milo. I always try to say it, and I get myself caught every time I say your name. Can you say it for me?
No, it's Melisizwe.
Melisizwe. Yeah, Melisizwe Brothers. Everybody says it different when I go online. Melisizwe Brothers. Love that. Does that have a meaning?
Yeah, Melisizwe, when we formed our group in 2015, and we love that name so much because it meant leaders of the future. And that was a name that we wanted to look up to. And so,
oh wow. You know, it's funny because I didn't know the meaning. I just assumed it was your last name.
Oh, our last name is James. But Melisizwe is our group name.
Well, you didn't like the James brothers?
Well, we
tried that.
We tried it. It
froze on me now.
But eventually we came to Melisizwe because our dad reads a lot of books, and we wanted a name that we could live up to. So Melisizwe meant leaders of the future. So we're like, that's an awesome name. Why don't we become leaders of the future?
I was just making a joke because I was just saying, you know, I was just picturing dad, what's wrong with our last name, you know? What's wrong with my last name? You're James. But no, that's nice. That's nice to know the meaning behind that. Beautiful. So what do you guys, again, you have Stadium. You have another song that's out now. Do you have a lot of original songs out? Can they get them on your website? Because I don't want to leave out. I know a lot of people see you singing covers online, but how many originals do you have, or you can't remember all of them?
Well, we have a lot of original songs
So we have on our Spotify page, there is an album of a mix of original music as well as cover songs. So if you head over to our Spotify page, the Melisizwe Brothers, you'll be able to find our entire collection.
Oh, perfect. So right now, the latest is Stadium, or do you have a newer song than that right now?
Our latest is actually Stadium.
Yeah. Okay. I saw Journey of Life, and I wasn't sure if that was brand new or before Stadium.
Yeah, we wrote Journey of Life actually in 2017.
Okay. So Stadium is. So now you won America's Most Talented Family, and you got signed with, is it Nickelodeon?
We actually got signed to Republic Records.
Yeah, Republic Records, sorry, through that. And you'll be working on an album with them, I assume, right?
We're really
excited. So far at home, we've been working back and forth with music with various artists like Debbie Gibson, Rob Lewis, and it's been really fun for us. We're working right after this is all over. We're working on starting a new tour with our new music, and we're really excited. But for now, we're just at home and we're just writing songs and making new records. But it's been really fun.
Okay. So do you guys have a release date for the album, or you don't know that yet?
Well, we're slowly coming up with the release date for the album pretty soon. And yeah, but right now we're just, you know, writing songs and everything. But yeah.
And this COVID thing isn't helping the situation either, right, guys?
Yeah.
Well, at least you can record from home. I see you guys making your stuff yourself. You know what you're doing. I know the studio guys can send stuff up on you and you get your vocals down and they can still keep working. So we're looking forward to that album coming out. I will definitely be sharing that when it drops and on all my social media. I'm so, 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 so proud of you guys and happy to finally meet you.
Yeah, Nice. Meeting you as well. Thank you for having
us. Thank you so much for being on the Tanya Mullings Show. I really appreciate it. I think we still probably have about 5 minutes. I don't want to get cut off with you guys, but I'm not sure if there's something that you want to sing on the way out or actually shout out some people before we head off the air, if you want to shout anybody out.
Well, we want to shout out to all our fans that are watching us. And we want to thank you for following our journey and everything and supporting us. And of course, our parents are probably watching right now as well. So
hi, Mom and Dad.
Hey, Danny, Mom. But, you know, that's all we want to shout out to the other people who supporting us along the way. So shout out to you guys.
And you do definitely have supporters and you earned every single one of them. So I just want to say to all my viewers, thanks again for tuning in to the Tanya Mullings Show here on the BarnBurner TV network on Zingo TV channel 250. And the Melisizwe Brothers were here with me tonight. I thank them so much. Make sure you follow them on social media. You guys want to lead us out with something before we go?
Yeah. We want to do I'll give you want to hear Stadium again. I think Stadium is a pretty good one. Is it?
Sure, that's their new single again. Go get it, the Stadium. And thank you guys for being on the show.
Yeah, no problem.
Maybe it's just the neon lights, but I see rainbows in your eyes. You've gone too far to turn back now. Your beauty's louder than the crowd, and you were there, but now we're here, and it's like time just disappears. We've got these chills, but all is still. The music stops. We fell in love in a stadium. We fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 folks in the sky, but it's only yours and mine inside this stadium. We fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 people get tonight, but it's only you and I inside this stadium. Hold your hand, I want to let you know. Oh, when the lights go on and everyone goes home, I'll never let you go. Oh, I want to hold your hand. I want to pull you close. I want to let you know. Oh, when the lights go on and everyone goes home, we fell in love in a stadium. Fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 iPhones in the sky, but it's only you and I inside this stadium. We fell in love in a stadium. 100,000 people get tonight, but it's only you and I inside this stadium.
Thanks, guys.